Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use HTML forms and checkboxes. So we'll cover the following topics. We'll first start off with a checkbox demo, and then I'll show you the actual HTML code for creating checkboxes, and then we'll pull it all together with a full JSP page example. All right, so a lot of good things in store here. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, so let's start off with the checkbox demo here. The user can enter their first name and last name. And now the new thing that's here is that they can actually choose multiple programming languages. So that's thanks to checkboxes. Previously, they can only use radio buttons and choose only one language, but now they can choose multiple languages, which is good, gives them more flexibility because we may personally like more than one language. And once you're happy with that, you can go and hit submit. And now our confirmation page is a little bit different. So now since they can choose multiple languages, then we'll simply display a list of all of the languages that they actually selected. So we'll do some slightly different coding here on our confirmation pages. But that's the big picture anyway. All right, so let's go ahead and look at the code here for HTML checkboxes. So it's very similar to radio buttons. The only difference is the actual input type. So instead of type radio, we say type equals checkbox. And other than that, everything else stays the same. So input type of checkbox, name, favorite language, value of Java, with the label off to the far right. And you can just repeat that process for each one of the languages, C#, PHP, and Ruby. So again, very similar. The only thing new is the type equals checkbox. All right, so now that the user can check multiple boxes, we need to change our coding up a little bit in our JSP page. So now in our JSP, we won't be able to use the little shortcut syntax of the $ curly brace param, because now we're going to get a lot of different values back. So what we can do instead is make use of the request object. So I'll say request.getParameterValues, and then I'll give the parameter name favorite language. So this getParameterValues will actually return an array of strings, right? That makes sense, right? Because they can choose multiple programming languages now. So it's going to return an array of strings. And then we'll write some JSP scriptlet code, and we'll actually loop through that array and print out a HTML list of the data. But anyway, things will be a little different when we get into the coding there for the JSP, and we'll make use of this technique for that. All right, so let's kind of pull it all together. So for this demo, or project actually, we're going to have a student checkbox form. They can enter their information, choose multiple programming languages, hit submit. Then that'll go over to a JSP. We'll give them their confirmation information, and then we'll loop through all languages selected and then display them as an HTML list. All right, so you know how I love to-do lists. So the first thing we have to do is create the HTML form, and then the second thing we'll do is create the JSP confirmation page. And what I'll do is I'll actually break this up and show it in a separate video as far as all the Eclipse coding. So I'll see you in the next video.